of the Jack Refix. Yo, what's up, guys? It's Hans Tucker, and today, welcome back to Need for Speed Boys 1 2005 on the channel. And well, in today's episode, we're going to do the races and then move on. So, we've done the pursuit milestones and stuff in the previous episode. Now, it's time to do the race events. In probably the slowest car that we own. But it'll be fine, right? Let's roll. I swear to God. Hey, I know I'm on Discord, but bloody hell. But actually, no, I've muted myself, so. And yes, in case you're wondering, guys, I will be doing I will be doing carbon after this. Carbon's really easy. Like, I'm not even joking, it's like, I think it's the easiest Need for Speed there actually is. So. And plus, the Evo is like the best tuner in the game. Well, this is just my opinion, man. The Skyline makes a comeback, but it's not as OP as it used to be, so. Also, update for the second channel. I haven't exactly been recording the emulated Let's Plays because, well, I've just forgotten about them, to be honest, and well, I can't actually use my PS4 back. I don't know what's up with PSX2, but let me know in the comments. Cracked it. There you go. So yeah, that's the thing, I'll be doing an update video on the second channel for you guys as a vlog. And also there's another update I want to do for the main channel. I might do that at some point. Don't know when, so you know. But we'll get it done. I thought the Evo was slower than this. So I don't know. Sleeper suffix was that. I just noticed that as well, that's the hilarious thing, I just noticed that. So, you're probably wondering, why am I using facecam? Good question. It requires syncing off audio and that's effort. That's just like too much effort for me, I can't be honest. Carbon's like OP. Like, you'd think the R34 is overpowered, but trust me, it really isn't. Like, that's actually quite upsetting for me because I'm an R34 fanboy, so you know, not that kind, as in Skyline kind, not that kind of R34. Just in case someone gets confused. I know someone probably will and be like, wait, what the hell does he mean? Anyway. I mean, I like the Supra, but the Supra isn't as powerful either. which is also depressing. But Omega Super is not a bad car, don't get me wrong. And this game is pretty good. But this thing carbon is not as powerful as you think it would be. And I'm just saying, if there isn't any commentary, I'll just upload this as a video anyway, just time lapse it. So it's not that much of a
guy, he's watching your back. I'm just wondering, you know, why he's doing it. It's a little weird if you ask me, but then again, who am I to judge? Maybe you guys met in jail. Later.
Yeah, I've always wondered that as well. Yeah, I'm just like, what? I don't know, man. Don't come down this way. Okay. What the f- That's a fruit salad in front of us right there. Oh my god, they have a failed race mobile. Oh, it doesn't have the strap. Look at that! Look at That's a fruit salad! That is literally a fruit salad on a car. That's amazing, man. Mini Evo in this game just kicks ass. You can get relatively early on as well. So it's like this thing it dominates. Thank you. wouldn't mind owning at some point as like a project car, as like a Lancer. Like, not an Evo Lancer, just like a standard Lancer. Just like the Lancer Evo Loop, like the Lancer that's in Need for Speed Underground, the first one. Like one of those. And you can, like, convert that to a Evo. Or has the Evo wing, has the Vertex spoiler, Evo hood, the original Evo hood, Evo body kit. And we put this wrap on it. Because this wrap is actually amazing. I know the Fast and Furious one is much more famous than this, but it's like, I never really were attached to that car. This Evo is definitely one of the cars I fell in love with. I'll be honest. Like, I love Mitsubishi. I love Mitsubishi cars. Evos are amazing. And if you can't afford an Evo, just get a Lancer. Because I'm guessing this is an Evo 8. Yeah. You put an engine swap in this, a big sod off one, put twin turbo in it, make it produce about 600 horsepower, give it an Evo look, you know? You're golden, though. I mean, I know people are buying Evo, but where's the point? Don't get me wrong, Evo is a solid car all around. But it's like, that's just a project car idea, man. Let me know what you guys think of that in the comments. It's a project car, man. Another one, actually, is another project car I've been thinking about. What was it? It's a... not a 350. I think it was, no. It was a, I'll have to come back to it, but it's... I don't remember it, I've got that. It'll come back to me. Ah, yeah, no. An M3. You know, so we can make THE M3. I'll check up M3. I mean, there is a guy who's already done it. He's pretty much... he has made his own M3 GTR. I'll leave a link to that in the description. I probably won't, to be fair, but I'll leave the guy's channel in the description. You know, that's probably the most achievable, like the Lancer and the BMW, like, probably the most achievable. And even if I can't get hold of an M3, again, yeah, as I said, I'm in Discord, so, but as I was saying, if I couldn't get hold of an M3, I'd get like a 330 diesel. Take the engine out of there, get the M5 V10, swap that in there, and make it look as accurate to the M3 as possible. You can't do that. That's annoying. What the fuck was that? A 350Z would be another project car, I think. I don't know. You see, I wouldn't want to make it like a stereotypical like drift car or something. But if I made a drift car, I'd want to make it so I'd drive it every day. But that would be the focus of my Skyline, my Alfa Romeo GTR. Because I love both the Supra and the R34 GTR, so I thought, I've just been thinking to myself, why don't I just merge the two together, keep the RB26 and take parts off the 2J, merge that into the R34's engine, of course with aftermarket pieces as well, and save the 2J and put that in a Supra. Get like one of those re-riced out ones, then de-rice it by buying proper parts. Like, I'd want to put a TRP kit on it, but at the same time I wouldn't. Whoa, we did two wheels, we did a very fair race approach. I don't know. Like, if I built a Supra, it'd be more for, like, handling. It'd be like, I want it to just be as grippy as possible. Like, you know, like, time trial kind of car. But again, daily usage. You've got to think about daily usage, because I don't want to build a car for the track and only have it on the track. I want to be able to drive that thing on a daily basis. Like, I think my project cars, I want to keep them as road legal as possible, but at the same time, I want to keep them as, I want to get them to be what they should be, like, say, a drift car or a drag car, but I want to be able to drive it on the road. Because I don't want to put, like, semi-slicks on a drag, on a track car, I want to be able to drive it on the road. I want to be able to drive the thing on the road as well. Let me know your opinions in the comments. Of course, these are just dreams, you know, of but I think Le Mans is probably one of the more achievable ones. And, like, a roadster as well. Not like an MX-5 and stuff, because that's been overdone in the UK at least. I don't know about anywhere else in the world, but, like, the MX-5 or Miata is, like, that's, like, one of the most overdone in the UK, actually. Because, Car Throttle's got one. I can't remember the guy. Well, one of the people on Car Throttle's got one. The main one. I can't remember, because he also did a off-road X-Type. Project Mud Type, if you haven't watched that, that's pretty good.
Off to take you out. I don't know how deep it goes, so watch yourself. Don't trust anyone till this blows over. I'll catch up with you later.
I don't know. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Like, I know they wouldn't be like the most reliable. I know they won't be like the most reliable daily car on the planet, but you know, that's the dream. I'd want to keep them as daily drivable as possible, as well as driftable, you know? I don't know, it's just been something I've been thinking about a lot recently. I don't know. Because my plan would be is to buy a Lancer, just like a stock Lancer off eBay or Water Trail or Gumtree somewhere in England. Preferably an automatic, 6-speed auto, that'd be nice. Because you know, I have hand issues, so feel free to check out my second channel for a bit more detail on that. Yeah. And a lot of people, car people, would be like, oh, why didn't you go manual? I won't be able to drive manual because of my hand. But yeah. I don't know. Speaking of cars, a while ago, I've been thinking about daily drivers as well, like, I gotta drive on a daily basis, that kind of thing. Like, personally for me, like, on, like, the high end of the spectrum, it'd be an SLS. Let's be honest, well, a bit showy off here. If it wasn't an SLS, it'd be an Aston Martin DB7. Actually, those are quite cheap now, they're like 17 grand in the UK. Another daily driver, which is mid-range, is i.e. 50 to 100 grand, that kind of range, is a BMW 430 diesel. Now you might be thinking, why don't I go for the 4-liter? Good question, whatever. Don't know. Because you see, with me and BMWs, I like the 330 diesel, the 530s and stuff. A nice BMW from a nice 3 Series Beamer from 2001 to around 2005. I'd be more than happy to have one of those. Obviously, all automatic. But, you know. Now, that's the kind of car I would buy with my own money. Obviously, but like, I'm pretty set on a Civic as like the first car I ever had. Civic would be my favorite. And I'm already imagining some of the comments in my head. Why don't I buy a Civic? Why don't I buy a Corsa or something? Because I don't want a Corsa. Because... Chaps. So yeah. Hold on, let me check anything. Yeah, the music's like turned off and yet it still thinks there's music being played in the game. That's really confusing. The Evo's not as slow as I thought. But you know, it's an Evo for you. Now that's a thumbnail. Oh man.
Yo, you're up. Jules is ready when you are. She may be a sweet girl, but remember, take her out and you're number 8 on the blacklist.
So guys, fuck's sake. Next episode, we'll be taking on Blacklist 8, and someone on my Discord, just saying that if I get a car, I'm going to sell it immediately and start and prepare for the arrival of the Bimmer. So I am going to buy a BMW, I'm going to buy the E46 next episode. Where is it? That's a Golf. There it is. I am buying one of these next episode. Of course it's not that. And of course, we'll be putting the almighty vinyl on it. So guys, next episode you'll be seeing us having a BMW E46 M3. Yeah. But thanks for watching, like, comment, of course, subscribe. And yeah. Let me know about your videos on cars. And you leave me some suggestions as well, like Peugeots, Hondas, because I'm set on a Civic, but if you guys feel that I should go with something else, let me know. How's my phone doing? My phone's not dead. That's actually surprising. My phone hasn't died. Okay. I should have... Oh, I haven't got my money either. You dick. Right. Oh, well. I apologize. Thanks for watching. Take care and peace. Yes, sir.